So today, guys, I'm going to be showing you how to build this little tool handle using the lathe. It's a very effective thing to be able to do to make your own tool handles, and you'll find you'll end up using this technique a lot. So let's get started.
So I'm making a handle for this file that I've had for a long time. I don't exactly know what happened to the handle I had with it, but this was long overdue, this project, and it's so simple to do. Like, literally in half an hour you could bang out one of these tool handles. So I'm just squeezing it into my chuck. This grip actually works pretty well, and I do this a lot on my square stock, so I have no problems with it. Some people like to round it over and then put in the chuck, but I just kept it like this for the whole project. So I just begin with my roughing gouge, just getting everything nice and round. Now, I don't know if it's exactly good practice to do this, but I was taught this from a woodwork teacher. When I'm trying to figure out if something's round, I actually put my chisel on it, and if it doesn't bump at all, it means it's nice and smooth, whereas I'll show you here, it starts bumping up and down. That means that you're hitting corners, so it's still not perfectly round. So I start using just my parting gouge just to define the size of the handle I actually want to use, and then I move on to using my spindle gouge just to get everything to shape and to get it to fit nicely in the hand. I recommend whenever doing tool handles to kind of have a shape similar to this, where you basically have somewhere where your fingers can push right up against, like a little rim. I just find it's very comfortable to hold, and also it just seems to work effectively. And I just use the spindle gouge and actually a bowl gouge as well, just to get into the tight corners like here. And I often use the point of the bowl gouge and kind of twist as I move, and you'll see in the video here how I kind of use the bowl gouge just to get into those little tight spots. Sometimes this is why it's great having a workbench you don't care about too much. I just got a drill bit and was just testing holes to see what kind of fit the chisel best, and just to help me figure it all out. Once I did that, I then, while the lathe was off, just started drilling into the piece of wood and then turning it with my hand to try and keep everything centered. Now it's just time to sand everything smooth, and I actually end up putting three lines at the top, and I just did this with the edge of a parting gouge, and it wasn't really too important anyway. So just sanded everything, then put my standard boiled linseed oil on, just got the bottom a bit more cut, and then cut it off using the sauce nice and safely, and sanded the bottom.
Now when you're hammering your foil or whatever wedge shaped thing you're putting into it, you should really look at the grain direction. Now I just got another piece of wood here just to give you an idea. If you look at the end grain, I've drawn in pencil the direction that the grain's going in. Now with your wedge, you want to put your wedge in this direction, so with the grain, so it's spreading with the grain. If you go like this, it's actually going to spread the grain apart and it's going to be more likely to crack. So this is by far the smarter way of doing it. If you hammer down, it shouldn't split. Now you just never know, and if you haven't drilled a hole big enough, it probably will split. So it's always a bit 50-50, so I'm about to do it with my tool handle, so wish me luck.
So this bit's quite nerve-wracking. Just make sure the hole's big enough. If you start getting a bit disconfident at all, pull it out and just drill a slightly bigger hole. But I was pretty confident here. I think there was a little crack in the end, but nothing too major, and I was happy with the fit of it all.
So I have to say, I was delighted with how the file turned out. It fits really nicely in the hand, so it doesn't, you want a handle a bit smaller when you're filing or rasping, because I find it's easier to hold, and this way of making tool handles is really easy. So my woodworker appreciation for this week goes to Sean Meehan. Doing this reminded me of when I was getting started on YouTube and not having really many tools to use, but still bringing out great projects, and that's what Sean does over his channel. He only has a couple hundred subscribers, so please check him out. He'd really appreciate it, and he deserves more subscribers. And it's nice to see another Irish person. If you've been sitting under a rock for years and you haven't seen Steve Ramsey's channel, please go check it out, because he did a great video for beginners on how to choose wood and to know what wood to choose for certain projects. And I really wish I had resources like that when I was started. So please go check that out as well. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It means a lot to me. And comment and rate on the videos. And if you haven't already, please check out my Twitter, my Lumberjocks, and also my Spreadshirt store if you want to help support the channel. So again, I just want to thank you very much for watching. And remember, a clean shop is a safe shop. Thanks very much.